not notice it, but at its core, Amores Perros is a love story. Now, when I say this, I don't mean Adam Sandler's 50 First Dates. Amores Perros is not an idealization of love, rather, it's a raw look at it. Through the narratives of three intertwined stories, Iñárritu is able to show the three stages of love, while using dogs as a motif for unconditional love. The first story revolves around Octavio and Susanna. Susanna is the wife of Octavio's brother Ramiro, who is an abusive husband. Octavio condemns the way his brother treats Susanna and plans to run away with her. This story shows the idealization of newfound love. Octavio is stubborn. He's adamant that things will all work out and that Susanna will comply. Throughout their story, Octavio says to Susanna that she just doesn't get it, and he isn't considerate of her circumstances.
No, tú no te das cuenta.
Disillusioned, Octavio insists on running away with her, even after Ramiro has been killed and Octavio has been involved in the car crash. He tells Susanna that he'll be waiting for her at the bus stop. The story ends when Susanna does not show up. It's really Octavio who does not understand. The second story involves Valeria, a model, and Daniel, who is a magazine publisher. Daniel has a wife and two children, a family he abandons to pursue a relationship with Valeria. All seems well until Valeria is crippled by the crash that ties the film together. The story represents the end of idealization. It's a phase where partners realize who each really is, contrary to the image they held when they fell in love. After the crash, Daniel and Valeria immediately start having problems. Their dog, Richie, has fallen beneath the floorboards, and Valeria is in a lot of pain. The true colors start to show when they began to criticize each other. The third story centers on El Chivo, an ex-guerrilla who left his family to achieve his political agenda. He was captured and now works as a hitman for the man who imprisoned him. El Chivo yearns for re-establishing a relationship with his estranged daughter and regrets his actions. The final story represents regret. Once all the damage is done after the end of idealization, people look back and reflect. They understand what they said wasn't right, and yearn for when times were better. El Chivo is approached by Gustavo, a man who wants a hit carry out on his brother. El Chivo agrees, but tricks the two. Tired of seeing families ripped apart, based on his past, he brings the two together and leaves it to them to settle things. His story ends when he breaks into his daughter's home to leave a message, one that expresses his regret and sorrow, and promises he will return when he gains the courage.
¿En qué he dejado de pensar en ti? La tarde en que me fui, te abracé, te cargué, te pedí perdón por lo que iba a hacer. Entonces, creía que había cosas más importantes que estar con tu madre y contigo.
Iñárritu also utilizes dogs as a motif for unconditional love. Dogs are man's best friend. They don't care what you look like, what you've done, or what you believe. They'll love you no matter what. This form of love is what the characters of Amores Perros yearn for. When Richie is stuck under the floorboards, the relationship with Valeria and Daniel starts to break down. Iñárritu places the camera on the floor to show the dark and foreboding abyss which Richie is lost in. This symbolizes the loss of unconditional love, as her two characters desperately tried to save Richie.
Richie!
At the end of the story, Daniel finds Richie, but he is hurt. This shows that the couple have found love again, but has been damaged, and they'll never see each other as they used to. It offers hope. Damaged love found with a chance of recovery. Another example is how El Chivo surrounds himself with dogs. He has formed no emotional connections for decades and fulfills his need to love with dogs. However, this is ripped away for him when Coffee kills all his dogs.
Roar?
Even though Coffee killed everything he had, El Chivo decides not to kill him. This is El Chivo's arc, as later we hear that he decides not to kill Gustavo's brother because of coffee.
Se parece a su perro. Y cómo decirte, si no fuera por él, ya estarías muerto, cabrón.
El Chivo has now learned the virtue of unconditional love, offering it towards coffee amidst all the damage he's done. Amores Perros translates to love's a bitch, and the title holds a double meaning. It refers to how, as seen with the motif, dogs are an embodiment of love. Secondly, it comments on how love really is a bitch. But does that mean we shouldn't?